acceleration. Okay?
It is a physical quantity related to velocity.
Now, the word seems or feels quite familiar because it is what we use in our vehicle, that is the accelerator, whether it is a car or a motorcycle. When you use the accelerator, the velocity of the vehicle increases or the speed of the vehicle increases. And the reason for that is because the acceleration of the vehicle is happening. Okay? And what is acceleration actually? The change in velocity of an object with respect to time is known as acceleration. So if the velocity of the object changes, then it is known as acceleration. Of course, the velocity will be changing with respect to time. And so, let's say that u is the initial velocity of an object. Now it can be anything. Even if the object is starting from 0, then 0 meters per second will be the initial velocity of the object. So u is equal to initial velocity and v is final velocity. So initial velocity and final velocity of the object. Now t will be given as time, obviously. And so according to the statement, acceleration A is change in velocity, that is final velocity minus initial velocity, in a certain amount of time. Okay? This is what acceleration is. Okay? Obviously, in acceleration we have velocity, and velocity is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. And so, acceleration is also vector. Acceleration is also a vector quantity. Understand? So, this means that acceleration of an object in motion also has a specific direction. That is why it is a vector quantity. Of course, you have magnitude as well. If you are solving this equation with the help of initial and final velocities along with the time, then whatever value that you are getting, that is the magnitude. So obviously magnitude as well as direction, and hence acceleration is a vector quantity. Now of course, acceleration is either positive or negative, which means that suppose a vehicle is moving and there is traffic or something happens in front of the vehicle, so the driver has to apply the brakes, and in that case the velocity is decreasing. So in that way also the velocity is changing once again. It is acceleration, but because the velocity is decreasing, it is known as negative acceleration. Okay? Negative acceleration, which is also known as retardation. And when you solve the answer for this in retardation, the value of acceleration that you get will be negative. Why? Because when you are applying brakes, the initial velocity of the object was already more, and when the brakes are applied, afterwards the velocity will be less. So in negative acceleration, the final velocity will be less than initial velocity. That is why when you solve this, A is equal to V minus U upon T, the value of V minus U will be negative, and in that way the value of acceleration will also be negative. The unit of acceleration is meters per second square. Don't get confused between velocity and acceleration. Velocity has meters per second and acceleration has meters per second square. Also written as just like meter second raised to minus 1. Meter second to the power minus 1. In the same way, this is meter second to the power minus 2. Same thing. Okay? Don't get confused. The unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Remember that. Okay, students. So we now perform a small numerical from the textbook, and the question states that boy pedals the bicycle progress to 6 meters per second in 30 seconds. So the very first statement itself is very important. Boy pedals the bicycle progress, that means it is in stationary position, which means that the initial velocity of the bicycle is 0 meters. becomes 4 meters per second.
So the final velocity is now 4 meters per second, and time to reduce this velocity was 5 seconds.
And the question is, calculate the acceleration for both the cases. So we first saw the acceleration for the first one, that is A is equal to B minus U on T. Simple. Substituting the values, B is 6 meters per second, initial velocity is 0, divided by time, that is 30 seconds. 6 minus 0 is 6 upon 30, 6.65, and 1 upon 5 is equal to 0.2 meters per second squared. Very simple, the first part of the question.
Moving on to the second part, okay? The acceleration, once again, is given by V minus U upon T. But now, the final velocity is 4. So we write 4 first. And then initial velocity, which was 6. So we write minus 6 upon time, which is only 5 seconds. So you solve this, 4 minus 6 becomes minus 2 upon 5. And what we get to it is 5 fourths. Remember, like I said, this minus sign over here